company new, isn't it? It ain't the new Beatles, it's the new Rolling Stones, new Bob Dylan, new Elvis Presley, new Sex Pistols. Well, we know we're having a new Zodiac Mind Warp. We haven't even finished with the last one yet. Me, I'm the new Bill Drummond. My record company boss, he wanted me to make a video with the kind of budget he was talking about. I don't think he could even get to Heathrow, let alone the grand visions I had of exotic locations, scantily clad girls. No. But it does give me the opportunity to talk to you about something vastly more important than my personal vanities. I wanted to do something that was more grown up with my life, you know, more important. I wanted to, when I get to 60, 65, whenever it is I retire, I'd like to be able to look back and think, I did something, I helped. But what can I do? I'd like to be able to stop the destruction of the rainforest, but foolhardy and more would it be for me, Bill Drummond, to single-handedly row up the Amazon and say, stop, don't cut down those trees. No. World peace. I joined CND. They didn't ban the bomb. And then there's that acid rain, isn't there? I could go out and buy an umbrella and that's about all. Now, what do I know about? The only thing is pop music. Pop music, that's all. That's it. Pop music. Now that I've cut all my ties, I haven't got any vested interests. No particular axe to grind. And from this station in life, I can look back across the plain, stretching out like a patchwork quilt. And over there, pop music. A land in a sorry state. Good husbandry is sorely needed. This is what I see as my responsibility. But up here, I've no influence, no currency. But down there, I'm just another sort of wilting weed in the sunflower patch going, look at me, any chance of the front cover? Do you think the record's going to go up next week? No. Far better that I stay up here, where at least I can see and rue the day that ever I descend. What is it that I find so abhorrent in my eyes? I know that in your heart, you know, along with the humble checkout girl in that megastore in Manchester, to the chairman of the BPI, they all know. Is it financially broke? Nope. They're bringing more money in 1 week into this green and pleasant land than the Beatles did over a whole year leading a complete invasion. Are the artists not having enough, say? More than enough. That every whim is being catered for. They've got pluggers, promoters, publicists, willing to crawl through a field of thistles to make their little boys hop, skip and jump. Is it morally bankrupt? Of course it is. It is pop music, you know. No, it's something far, far worse. It's the music. The music. The music is spiritually bankrupt. There is nothing there. The vestry is bare. There is no belief, no faith, not even atheism. Just remixes. And retreads, and renegotiations, and the poor old music press, rewriting the histories. So this is what I'm going to do. I am going to become the manager of the complete music thing in this country, from that bedroom duo in Burnley to Duran Duran. The manager of every record shop, every bootleg pressing plant, from fledgling indie label with a first single just about to come out to the mighty CBS. The MCPS, the PRS, the Musicians Union, the BPI, the complete music press. Every radio station and all the pop TV programs. Nope, I'm not going to come down there and saw my hands, get involved with the day-to-day problems. I'm sure you're more than capable of doing that yourselves. You don't have to change your corporate structures either. It just so happens I'm at the top in charge. Not everything has to change. Girls still need to scream. Boys hear a whoosh. Millions still have to be made overnight. But so much more has to go. This is for starters. One, musicians are not allowed to spend any more than 10 days recording any one LP and no remixes. I've seen whole chunks of life being lost in the complete Hampton Court of 32-track digital machines. Songs have to be written, not layered. Two, the musicians' union, representing all their artists, have to formulate a standardised contract with all the record companies. Maybe reviewed once a year. Imagine a coal industry where every miner employed a lawyer to tackle the coal board. Ludicrous. And we've got all these music business lawyers running around negotiating and renegotiating what amounts to the same contract every time. You think they'd have something more interesting to do with their lives? Three, as for advances, they go. We don't have them anymore. If there's one thing that's dried up the spunk in our music, it is the advance. All they're there for is so managers can stand and compare sizes with each other. Now, if all a manager can do is land a big advance, he should be sent packing. It's a well-known fact that no really great music has ever come from a band that's got themselves a big advance. Imagine if they paid me on Monday. How many streets do you think I'd get swept by Friday? Obvious. So like everybody else, they should get out there and earn the keep. And if they sell some records, fine, they earn royalties. Radio 1, pop TV programmes. Fine, they can stay as they are until further notice. I imagine you find my instructions pretty impractical. Well, that's just too bad. You're gonna have to find ways and means. It'll keep those lawyers busy sewing up the loopholes, taking the transgressors to court. Sounds like a remix, boy. 3 years, sonny. And what do I get? Other than the warm glow, the satisfaction of knowing that it's me that's put our little world to rights. I'm not asking for 20% commission. I'm not even asking for 15%. I'm not asking for any commission whatsoever. I just want you to feel free to write to me, the manager, Box 283, Aylesbury, Bucks, about any problem you might have concerning your area of pop, enclosing a cheque for £100. Every letter I receive will be dealt with in the strictest confidence. And once the cheque is cleared, I will write back to you, giving my personal guidance. And before you say don't, this papa ain't going to stop, because I believe in rock and roll.